Follow the funk from the skunk in the dank that is crunk in the dungeon. It goes on and on and on like, so hallelujah, hallelujah. One for the players at the crib drinking drinks, and two is for the sound Hootie Hoo that I made. Hootie Hoo.
Tight like hallway, smoked out.
Hootie Hoo.
Big Y on my left, Andre's on my right. Tight like hallway, smoked out.
Hootie Hoo indeed, Kennesaw fans. Welcome to Impact Media's weekly show all about everything KSU Owls, including hockey, rugby, and of course football. Hootie Hoo. What Owls do, they Hootie Hoo. I'm Jeremy the Impact York. Want to welcome you guys in. Got a lot of fun stuff to talk about tonight. The Owls are always busy. We do have a hockey note. We do have some rugby things to get into. Plus, outside of talking some Kennesaw football, as I have teased on our Georgia and our Georgia Tech show, I will officially weigh in on some of the national topics that we have discussed up until this point. But first, I want to tell you guys all the ways you can be a part of this show. You can follow us on all the social medias. If you look for at Team Impact Media on Twitter, that will list all of our shows, including this one. You can just scroll the appropriate show, click on it, and listen as many times as you want. There is no cap. You can search for us on Facebook by searching for Hootie Hoo or Impact Media. You can email us 3endzone@gmail.com. You can also follow myself for show-related things and non-show-related things. Anything I think just could be fun, I will post up there. Some cool things we end up doing at TheImpact99 on Twitter, Triller, TikTok, and Instagram. We're working on getting some more stuff up on the Triller and the TikTok. We are, like I said, working on some fun stuff. I think you guys are going to enjoy that. So, what has happened in the world of Kennesaw? Well, for one, I went to the KSU alumni rugby game, got this really, really wicked sick shirt. This is super cool. Told you guys I needed some more swag. Was glad to find they had a bunch of really good shirts, but I got caught up in talking to a lot of people. Only got the chance to get the one shirt. I will be getting some more later. Shout out to the Alumni Association of KSU Rugby. I did not realize how extensive and how great alumni they have. There were some really, really talented people out there. Of course, it was fun getting to run into Coach Matt, and shout out to his amazing fiance as well. Haven't seen either one of them since the last rugby ATL game. It was great getting to run into them again, chat for a few minutes, and wished him the best for this upcoming season and his upcoming wedding. But that is the most I will say about that particular event on this show. I guess we started off on rugby. We'll start right there. Quick evaluation of the game, the alumni versus the actual KSU team. I would say there was a couple people got dinged up here and there. I think it just looked like minor tweaks. Most of the time it looked like ice was on an ankle, ice was on a shoulder, you know, things like that. The alumni brought it. The KSU alumni, they were really bringing it out there. They were definitely not as fast and as quick as the actual Owls team, but they were some big physical dudes, and they were using that size advantage a lot of times to gain advantage on the pitch. And they did a pretty good job. I didn't really keep up with the score. It looked pretty even to me. I think there's definitely some stuff to, like I said, talk to Coach Matt Heaton. There's definitely some stuff he saw that he wants to work on. I would say the team's coming along pretty well. This is a fairly young bunch. There's a lot of them that kind of grew up, and there's a nucleus that have kind of arrived together. I think that's going to be a lot of fun. But, not really, but, there definitely some stuff they need to work on. The tackles, a little bit. The tackles weren't bad, especially a big, powerful team. But I'm pretty sure one of their first games is going to be against Life University. That's going to be a big, physical team. So you got a pretty good tune up there. But like I said, what I really like about it was you were able to get the alumni together. Had a really good turnout. We definitely packed the rugby field all along there. All the bleachers, a lot of people had blankets and chairs and stuff of their own that they brought. And it was just overall a really, really good time. Glad I got a chance to make it out to it. We're going to try to make it to as many rugby games as we can this year. Their schedule is posted. If you go to, I believe, KSU Rugby on Instagram, or just reach out to us and we'll try to send you the schedule. Cause like I said, I have it somewhere. I think I've posted it before. Maybe I'll repost it. But other than that, had a really good time. I did not realize how much I missed seeing live rugby until I was standing on the sideline, eagerly anticipating this thing starting. And it was just spectacular. So great to be out there. So great to see. I got to talk to some of the players and some of the alumni. I didn't do any formal interview, stuff like that, just chit-chatting. And Kennesaw Rugby is really in a good place. Talk to the assistant coach as well. It's in a good place. I feel pretty good about this season that they're going to really make some strides and really build this program the right way. So once again, shout out to Coach Matt and everybody who made that event possible. And shout out to the alumni for showing up and representing. Let's get into the hockey, right? The hockey note for now, let's go ahead. It's more than official now. I am the voice of KSU hockey until proven otherwise. It looks like they are solidifying the other parts of our broadcast team and staff, and we're going to have some person who's running the video. I believe it's a former player. I swear I knew who it was, and let's see if we can find that real quick. We're great podcasting, by the way, or great video casting, as you guys are watching me try to look for it. It is, I think it, didn't he, I don't want to be wrong. It is, yep, Connor Whelan. He's an alumni player. He's going to handle the camera for this year's broadcast. It should be a real blast. I already talked to Coach Matt with the rugby team. They're going to try to make it out to some games. We're going to try to get some of the hockey guys out to some rugby games. It's going to be fun. It's going to be a lot of fun, guys. And to put those two programs side by side, it's not only going to help each one build, but they're going to realize there's a lot more in common than just both playing collegiate sports. Rugby and hockey have a lot of parallels on and off the playing surfaces, and the strategies and the way you look at things, it's going to be a good thing to have them together. Actually, you know, we'll work on, I know a lot of them attend the football games. We'll try to get some of the football guys out to some of these and see what we can do with that. But, I think that was the hockey. Oh no, they're having tryouts and evaluations and meetings that involve all of those coming up. Go to KSU Hockey on Instagram for all the info on that. If you have trouble finding it, let me know. I will reach out to the contacts I have with this team and try to get that info for you. And somewhere in the not so distant future, because the first home game is October 13th, I believe. Wow, is that a Friday the 13th? That's going to be interesting. But between mid-October and I think mid-November, or no, late November, There are four Friday home games, two Saturday home games, and some away games tucked in there in between it. They're going to play UGA a couple times. You guys want to see UGA lose, right? You tune into this show. You want to see UGA lose. Or if you're a fan of our UGA show here on Impact Media and you want to show up to see UGA maybe beat Kennesaw, good luck with that. But feel free to come hang out just as well. They were going to play all their games at the Cooler in Alpharetta. I think I can announce that now. And what else can I? I think that's everything. You know, there's a lot of stuff I've been holding from you guys. I had to wait till I could say a lot of it. But, you know, a lot of good things happening with hockey, too. Rugby's underway. Hockey's going to be starting very, very soon. We'll be talking more about it as it comes up, obviously. But other than that, let's jump into football. Now, our Kennesaw Owls went up to the University of Tennessee, Chattanooga. I believe that's where Terrell Owens played, if I'm not mistaken. He obviously didn't play this game. But, you know, first half, really, it seems like they were doing a lot of really good things, doing a lot of Kennesaw things, but just not quite executing when it counted. It was 17-0 Chattanooga at halftime. But I have a lot of faith in the Owls, and so do you. Because they scored 20 points in the second half. Unfortunately, on top of the 17 they scored in the first half, Chattanooga scored another 10. They win this game 27-20. It was early on. Chase Artopius is what I'm going to go with. He found Sam Phillips for a 15-yard touchdown in the first quarter. It was 7-0 Chattanooga. Jude Kelly hit a 26-yard field goal. That was a good stop for our defense, but they still got the field goal. They're up 10-0 there. They'll go up 17-0 on the Chase Artopius finding Sam Phillips again for 12 yards. Jude Kelly with the kick. That's the 17-0. Then Jonathan Murphy scampers for 29 yards and the score. Connor Cummins puts it between the uprights as only he can. Then Artopius found Javin Watley for a 32-yard score there. It's 24-7. But our guys didn't give up because they answer at the end of the third quarter with a Connor Cummins 41-yard field goal. That dude can kick. I don't know how Kennesaw keeps finding these amazing kickers. I remember the last time that I was able to cover the football team, they had a couple amazing kickers. Justin Robertson, or it was something like that. And I hate that I can't remember your name. I will figure that out. But Connor Cummins, 41 yards. That's 24-10. We're only down two scores going into the fourth quarter. Well, Jude Kelly adds a 21-yard field goal early on, puts the lead at 17. And then Jonathan Murphy found Gabriel Benyard for 29 yards and the score. And then Connor Cummins adds a 19-yard field goal with about 3:42 to go. We unfortunately were not able to capitalize and put another score up. We fall 27-20. We're 1-1 on the season. Haven't gotten into conference play, so not that concerned yet. I see Coach trying some stuff. I see Coach moving some people around. He's getting ready for conference play, and when that starts, look out. It's taking the reins off the horse, and the horse is going to run around the track all by himself. Where is it? There we go. Give you guys some stats for this. Jonathan Murphy, 12 for 16, 181 in the air. That's 11.3 per pass. I'm okay with that. One touchdown, no interceptions. He had a good day. I'll take that from the way this offense is. And they evenly disperse the running. So it's going to sound here in a minute like nobody had a big running day, and they did only total about 100 yards, but Jonathan Murphy ended up with 32 yards and a touchdown. Michael Benefield had 29 yards. Gabriel Benyard had 25, so you could call him out of the backfield for that other one. Preston Daniels had a 14-yard run. It was pretty amazing. And Alexander Dix, I'd be remiss if I didn't mention his effort. They were trying different things. When something didn't work, they tried something different. When something didn't work, you modify it, you try it a little differently. Just kept trying things. Couldn't quite find the thing that was going to work and put them over the top. Although, like I said, they stayed in it till the end. Two field goals, two touchdowns. That's a pretty good day. Unfortunately, you fall a little short. Now, Benyard did have three receptions for 123 yards, which is a 41-yard average. He did have a long touchdown as well. Isaac Foster, once again, I can't call him old, and I can't call him anything referencing his age because I'm close to twice his age. So, and I'm not old. So, Isaac, you just keep hanging on, buddy. But he had a couple big catches. Blake Bohannon had a big grab. So did Connor Fine. Carson Kent got in on the action. Alexander Diggs, Rowan Darnell, and Tykeem Wallace. If they can get Wallace in space, man, I don't think anybody's going to catch him. He's that fast. Did have a couple. Did have an untimely fumble. Just didn't quite, help things out so much. But we did recover the one. I think Ronnie Thomas recovered the fumble, and that definitely helped. I told you about the kicks. Connor Cummins hit a 41-yarder in the, was it the 19 or the 20? I think it was 23-yarder. He accumulated 8 points all by himself. That's pretty amazing that he had about 40% of the points on the night. And Joshua Hewitt is, I mean, you couldn't pick the ball up and go put it on the turf any better than he does by kicking it off his foot. He pinned them deep a couple times, especially inside the 20. His longest punt of the night was a 58-yard punt. That's amazing. Just amazing. 8,123 people just at about half capacity for that stadium up in Finley Stadium in Chattanooga came to see that one. That's not bad. I know some friends of the show and some friends of mine were at the game. They were able to take it in with some alumni and things like that, and look a good time. It really did. Up next, of course, Kennesaw has a home game. They will be back against Furman. That is this Saturday, 5 p.m. kickoff. We will also be on ESPN+. I say we because I will be at the game as well. And before we get into previewing the game, I will bring up my offer to you guys, people listening, people watching. I'm going to try to get there a little earlier than last time. That was on me. I'm going to try to get there earlier. If you see me walking around, I promise you I am in a vest and tie, and I am probably the most overdressed person there. That's for people who don't know, that's just when I cover media, and I actually prefer to wear that style of clothes. If you find me walking around, you need to do two things. For one, you need to greet me with a Hootie Hoo. You can say it however you want. You can say Hootie Hoo. You can say Hootie Hoo. You just say Hootie Hoo. How are you going to say it? You do that one thing. And then the second thing you need to do is we'll take a picture. It can be a selfie. It can be a non-selfie. Doesn't matter. Maybe that was what was scaring you guys. Take a picture of us. Post it on social media. Tag us all in it at the Impact 99, at Team Impact Media, any of that, hashtag Hootie Hoo, any of that. And if you do those two things, the first two people to do that at this Furman game, we will walk over to the team store and I will buy you a brand new Owls t-shirt. of your choice within reason. No sweatshirts, no jerseys, no, you know, maybe you could negotiate if you'd rather have some novelty, maybe a stuffed owl or something like that. But I promise you, we will swag you out compliments of Impact Media. You just have to find me. And it's not like a Where's Waldo. Most of the time I'm out kind of walking around, doing videos, getting a lay of the land, so to say. That's all you have to do is find me. The first two people that greet me with a Hootie Hoo and that take a picture, tag us on social media. All you got to do is, once you tag it, show me. Which, for one, it'll come up. It'll come up on my phone. I'll have my phone on me just for that reason. Do that. And I promise you, the first two people to do that, we're going to walk right over to the store. You're going to pick out a new Kennesaw shirt. You're going to be swagged out. And then moving forward, the other home games against Tennessee State, Lincoln, and Virginia of Lynchburg, it'll be back down to one. The only reason I'm doubling up is I got there a little later than I wanted to the first game, and you guys didn't have a lot of opportunity to find me walking around because I was not walking around much. When I got there, I pretty much was straight in the booth. But the first two people, no joke, that's I don't know of a better deal. I don't know of a better deal than that. You wanted a brand new Kennesaw shirt? And if there's somebody in your party, maybe you have a new shirt and you were going to get a shirt for somebody else if they're in your party. Great, we'll get it for them. You can pick out the size and the style of your choice. So if you want to get your wife, your girlfriend, your husband, your daughter, your grandmother, random person walking next to you, whoever you want to get the shirt for, fine with me. And in fact, at that point, I'm going to go ahead and throw this last part. As soon as we do that, we're going to take another picture and put it up. And we want you to show off proud. We want to show it off proud, you know? So, Furman. Furman's going to be pretty busy. They're going to play a lot of people this year that are going to be some fun matchups. Furman are 1-1 coming into this game. I did have their schedule pulled up. Let me see if I can find it again. There it is. Furman so far this year, they opened up with a giant win, 45-10 over Tennessee Tech. That's a pretty good win. We talked about this on the Georgia Tech show, or on the Georgia show, because South Carolina is going to play Georgia this week. South Carolina almost doubled them up, or they did more than double them up, 47-21 last week, but 21 points on South Carolina, that's pretty good there. Like I said, then Furman, they will be in Kennesaw to take on our Owls this Saturday on ESPN Plus at 5 p.m. or great seats still available. Last I checked, there were still seats available. Come pack the place out, you know. Their quarterback is not having a bad year. I'll give him that. I mean, you see all the points he scored. He is Tyler Huff. Tyler Huff is 29 for 51 for 301 yards, one touchdowns, and two interceptions. It happens. Their leading rusher is Dominic Roberto. And Dominic has 27 carries for 79 yards and three touchdowns. He is a red zone magnet from the sound of it. Their leading receiver with six receptions and 107 yards is Kendall Dean. And those are the people we're going to have to watch out for. But we got Joe Murph. We got Ben Yard that's kind of come out of nowhere. Not really come out of nowhere, but he started to shine. The good thing with this Kennesaw team, and this is what I remember from before, is there's so many weapons, there's so many moving parts that you're just going to get the opportunity. Like, if you shut down one, then there's, you know, you're like, well, we're going to shut down this running back. And then another one steps up. And so you shut down that one, and then another one. And as soon as you think you got the running game under control, what do? They pass on you. And then now you start stepping back. Well, now they get a running back going again. Or Joe Murph just takes off, or John Murph, I guess is what I should call him. John Murph should just, he'll just take off down the field, and you won't know what just passed you until you see him celebrate. But this is going to be a fun game. We should get pretty good weather. I think it's going to be in the low 80s. A little bit of cloud cover should be nice. Maybe a little wind. A little wind would be nice. But Fifth Third Bank Stadium, it'll be action at the fraction. Shout out John Nelson. Action at the fraction. Hopefully, we see you guys there. Hopefully, as I said all of last year about KSU hockey, about anything in general, the at the absolute least, the first way and the easiest way for you to help support something like KSU rugby or KSU hockey or KSU football or anything that you're trying to support, maybe it's another organization or whatever, but the easiest thing you can do is to follow that organization or follow that team. Follow KSU rugby, follow KSU hockey, follow KSU football. The second easiest way that you can help support it, these cost $0, is to tell someone about KSU football, KSU rugby, KSU hockey. Tell someone about it. Those cost $0. So all you need to do is follow along and tell somebody about it. It's not much simpler than it can't be much simpler than that. But that's going to do it for us this week. Shout out to all you amazing Owl fans that have made it so welcoming to be back on the KSU side of things. It's been really great. Yes, we do miss a lot of our friends at other places and things we've covered. But we look forward to a lot of really fun things we have going with Kennesaw right now. And I hope you guys are as enthusiastic about I am, as enthusiastic about it as I am. See, I can't even talk. I'm just so into it. But other than that, that will do it for this week's show. Hope to see you guys out at the game. You guys know all the fun ways that you can follow us. And until then, what do owls do? They hooty hoo. See you next week.
Follow the funk from the skunk in the dank that is crunk in the dungeon. It goes on and on and on like so. Hallelujah, hallelujah. One for the players at the crib drinking drinks, and two is for the sound. Hootie hoo that I made. Hootie hoo.